per year.
And you add 4 each time?
Okay, so walk me through how you figured out that you're adding 4 each time.
For me, I pretty much forget how I did it, but then to double check, I just kind of
added 4 and made sure.
Yeah.
I got it 24.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's dwell on that for just a second. Like, how might we figure out? We've got all this blank space in between. How do we figure out that it goes up by 4 every time without just guessing and then making sure that it works out? What's a more direct mathematician type of approach? Woody?
What I do is I find out how many words between each of them, the 1 and the 5 and the 4, and the 16.
So you take. From 1 to 5 is 4, and then from 8 to 24
16.
Is 16.
And I divided by 2, and then I got 4.
So 16 divided by 4 is 4 every time. That makes sense. We can kind of see it visually over here. If we if we look at what Morgan did, you see from here to there is 16. And it's taking us 4 days to get there, right? Here's 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days. So every day should see the same increase. And that, by definition, is dividing 16 by 4, taking 16 and dividing it into 4 groups. Go up by 4 this day, and by 4 this day, and by 4 this day. Take us up a total of 16 that we need to go. Very good, very good. So we see that there's a change of 16 in the y, there's a change of 4 in the x. We just divide the change in y by the change in x, and we figure out how much the y is changing every x. Right? Jay? Sorry, you need?
No, what?
Something you need?
No.
Anything you want? Okay. So if we don't quite this talk of x and y is kind of abstract, let's give some story to it. All right. Let's say that x represents days. Right? X represents days, so 1 is 1 day has gone by, 2 is 2 days gone by, 5 days have gone by. What could Y represent?
Apples.
Yellow.
Apples, what's the context here? Apples that you, we're not picking apples that slowly,
yeah.
Are you? Okay, you are. You're picking apples that slowly. Could we change the days then? Maybe we'll change days to
minutes.
Minutes? Minutes is good. So this number 4, what does that become? 4 what's for what?
Minutes. Minutes.
4 minutes?
Oh,
yeah. Well, the 16 divided by, okay, so 16, what is 16? 16 what?
Apples.
16 apples. What's the 16? Where's the 16 apples? What are we talking about? 16 apples. Okay, 16. So it's not that we have 16 apples at any time, though we might at some point. But we're saying that from 8 apples to 24 apples, the increase is 16 apples.
Oh.
Right? So between minute 1 and minute 5, I picked an additional 16 apples. 16 apples every 4 minutes. Conveniently, 16 is divisible by 4, so we can divide it evenly up into 1 minute segments. 4 apples per
minute.
1 minute. 4 apples per minute. Now that we've figured out that every minute we pick 4 apples, can we use that to jump out to 26 minutes. I mean, really, we could start anywhere we want. We could start at 5 minutes, at 1 minute. We could find some number of apples in between or before that and just go from there. Let's say we start at minute one.
Hold on just a second.
Get the phone.
Okay, so let's say we start at minute one. How many apples do we have after the 1 minute?
Four.
Yeah, I mean, in 1 minute we'll pick four, but at minute number one, how many apples do we have?
Eight.
Eight, okay.
That's two minutes?
Yeah, that's weird. I mean, it's we're picking four apples per minute, but at minute one we have eight apples. How could that be?
You start with four.
So we just start with four apples just because, from the day before, or?
Yeah, you do a complimentary four apples.
Maybe we're going to an apple orchard and we're just picking apples and they're like, here's four to start with. And then you pick four per minute after that.
They can be four.
All right. We got another question up here. Listen to Nicole's question.
Never mind.
Nope.
Never mind.
All right, so we started, well, not started, it's a 1 minute. We have eight apples, which must mean we, if we pick 4 minutes per app, four apples per minute, we must have started with four from the very beginning for no reason in particular. Okay, then we pick four more, we're at eight, we'll pick four more, four more, four more, four more, we're up to 24. Okay, how are we going to figure out how many apples we have at 26 minutes? Jasper has an answer to how, with the information we now have, are we going to figure out how many apples we have in 26 minutes?
Eight.
So we start with eight apples.
Yeah.
Because at minute after minute one, Dustin, Jaden? You guys have thoughts? All right. So we're starting with the eight apples right here at minute one. We're going to add some apples to that, clearly. We're going to gain apples.
Plus 4 times 26 minus 1, which is 25.
Okay, so explain us the reasoning behind 25.
Because that's how many we are away from 26.
That's how many are we when we're at minute 1, we're 25 minutes away from 26. So this analogy works well with what Jasper explained to us the other day, right? Minute 1. How many more minutes until minute 26? 25. So 25 minutes, picking four apples per minute, added on to the 18 we had at minute one, should get us all of the apples that we had at minute 26. Well, 4 times 25 is easy. It's 100. Right? Plus 8, 108.
108. I did it a different way, like this. Problem, but I still got the same answer.
Okay. Let's just make some room. All right, Jaden, what'd you do?
I forgot what I did. I know it was different, though. Okay. So my homework.
Do you remember anything about it?
Can you stop saying zero?
Oh, yeah, I do.
Not really. All I remember is that I did the problem different.
Wow.
Yep.
Okay.
That's all I remember.
I did mine different.
You did it differently.
Me and Cody.
What did I do different?
You did something different? What did you do different?
Yeah, I
did.
So, oh, okay. Okay, now I remember. Okay, so I kept on continuing like 10. I did 10 over, I think it was 44.
10 over 44?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, where did 10 over 44 come from?
Well, because I kept on continuing. I forgot the rest of things. But 10, like, it started going up by 4, so I went up by 4. So I got to 10.
You started at 5 minutes and went
up
4 more minutes?
Yeah, I started at 5 minutes and I had 4 more, so I got 10.
Well, wait a minute. What's 4 more minutes after 5?
9.
Okay. Well, so you said 10.
Yeah. Right.
So where did the 10 come from?
I don't know.
Me and Mac worked on it together after school, so.
So it was, but you're saying 10, what, 10 minutes?
Yeah.
Well, I'm just saying that, like, if we go up 4 minutes, which I get that, if that makes sense, just go up another 4 minutes. But if we go up 4 minutes from 5 minutes, we're at 9 minutes, not 10 minutes.
I
mean, we could keep going. Go to 9 minutes, then go 4 more minutes to 13 minutes. Right? Is this what? Does this look like what you did?
Yeah.
Okay, so just keep going up in blocks of 4 minutes each. Go up another 4 minutes. We're at 17 minutes. Go up another 4 minutes. We're at 21 minutes. Go up another 4 minutes. We're at 25 minutes. We're close to 26 minutes. Okay, as we're going up by 4 minutes each, well, how many apples are we going to pick as we go up 4 minutes? Like, if I add 4 minutes on, how many apples am I going to gain as I go up 4 minutes?
16.
Another 16. I mean, 4 apples per minute is the same as 16 apples per 4 minutes. So another 16, and that gets us up to 40?
I think so.
Yeah. And another 16 gets us up to 56, and another 16 gets us up to 72. Another 16 gets us up to 88. Another 16 gets us up to 104.
Yeah.
104. And now we're 1 minute away from minute 26. So then we can just figure out like how many to add on for 1 minute, which we know is 4. And there we are. We're at, of course, 108. Just four. So that's good. I mean, it's certainly a lot faster than going, as I see many times, like going from minute 5 to minute 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, counting 1 by 1 by 1, counting 4 by 4 by 4. That's a good way to go too. Okay. So there's several nice approaches.
Wait, can you say what you said about the extra minute thing?
Well, just that if we do what Mac was describing is just going up by 4 minutes each, just keep on adding 4 minutes. If we do that, start at minute 5, we go to 9, 13, 17, 21, we get to minute 25 following that, but we're asking about minute 26, so we need to go 1 more minute to get to minute 26.
Oh, okay.
And we went up by 16, 16, 16, 16 apples, 16 apples. But then in 1 minute, we happen to need to do this calculation still. How many apples do we get in that 1 more minute?
4.
Because, well, we've gone up by 4 minutes, 16 apples, that must be 4 apples every 1 minute. And so we go up by 4 more apples, 108.
Yep.
Okay, let me just take all of this and we'll create like a kind of put it all together, create like one solid approach here. I can erase some of this stuff. Just go back to what we had before. Okay, we'll leave out for 1 day. All right, we're trying to jump past 26. All right, so I think in all these approaches, it was very handy to know how many apples per minute were being picked. Well, I think the quickest way we found was to say, well, we have 24 in minute 5. If we take off the 8, take off the 8 that there were in minute 1, how many apples is that? 16 apples. And then if you take minute 5 minus minute 1, 4 minutes have passed. And so having 16 is divisible by 4, so we can simplify that nicely to 4 apples every 1 minute. 4 apples per minute, right? 16 divided by 4 is 4, 4 divided by 4 is 1, 4 apples per minute. Now using that 4 apples per minute, let's just find a way to jump from some whatever minute we want up to 26 minutes. I think the kind of approach that we can duplicate for any situation would be something like this. where we start at, say, minute one with its 8 apples, and we add on how many minutes?
4 seconds.
What's that?
8.
Well, how many minutes are going to go by from 1 minute to 26 minutes? 25 minutes. We add on 25 minutes of picking how many apples every minute? 4 apples every minute. Okay. I think if we were to use that approach every time, whatever the numbers we get, whatever we're talking about, minutes and apples or days and people or whatever those variables represent, that approach will work pretty much every time. We need to play with it a little bit. If the numbers are a little different, we just have to figure out like how many minutes are going by or how many days have gone by or whatever. But still, find out how many per day or per minute, whatever it is, how many you start with on a given minute, and how many minutes are going to go by, right, times that many per minute. Now let's write a formula, which means we can just plug an x in there for however many days. Well, that's going to have a lot of the same things in common. Let's still start with 8 plus, well, we're still going to multiply 4 by something, right? 4 times the number of minutes that go by.
X minus 1.
We can see the x minus 1 right there. 25 minutes go by if we want to get to minute 26, starting at minute 1. If you want, though, could we back up to the very beginning, before you started picking apples, okay, what Bella brought to our attention? Like, doesn't that mean, like, if we have 8 apples at minute 1, does that mean we're picking 8 apples per minute, or does it mean that was 2 minutes? Well, it's a good question to ask, but really what it meant was we started with
4
apples. We just back up 4 apples, because we just need to back up 1 minute to the very beginning of the time that we started picking apples. Okay. So 0 minutes, 4 apples in the basket or the bag, whatever you pick an apple and putting them into. Well, if we start there, we start with 4 apples, we're going to add on some apples. We're going to add 4 apples per minute. And how many minutes are going to pass between minute 0 and minute 5? How many minutes are going to go by between minute 0 and minute 5? How many minutes will pass between minute 0 and 5? How many minutes will pass between minute 0 and minute 26?
25.
We're starting at which minute?
0.
Minute 0, right?
26.
So, don't berate people. Going up, berate. Go up 26 minutes, you're at minute 26. Okay, how many minutes until minute X? Exactly, X minutes. Just X, not X minus 1, because we're starting at minute 0 as opposed to minute 1. So, X. Yes, 4 plus 4X. We could also distribute the 4 into this parentheses. Combine 8 and negative 4, you get 4 plus 4X. And we find that those two formulas are identical. All right, let's try it again. We'll see if we can handle some data here that has a little bit of a skip in the middle. So I'm going to figure out how many apples per minute or people per day or whatever the variables you might choose to give that story. Alexander, what did you get?
162.
Who else got 162?
I got 255.
255?
I got 252.
72?
I got 165.
I got 165 too.
Okay, well, let's settle this heated debate. Well, let's just use this approach, because this approach will work every time, basically. Let's figure out, can we talk about minutes and apples again, just to give them some context, okay? Well, how many minutes have gone by?
5
minutes have gone by. 5 minutes. 7 minutes. How many apples were picked
15.
In those
15?
5.
15.
Okay, so 15 apples.
Divided by 5.
Divided by 5 minutes.
It's 3.
It's 3 what?
3 apples per minute.
3 apples per minute. It's a good rate. The rate at which the apples are changing with the minutes. Let me just ask you a quick question. If we actually picked some apples and we kept track of how many apples we had at any particular minute, do you think it would come out really nicely every time? Just like 3 apples every minute. Why not, Brandon?
Probably because there's going to be different numbers involved.
Yeah, maybe, you know, 1 apple is really high and it's hard to get to, so it took us longer and we didn't get as many apples that minute, right? So we're kind of assuming some things, and let's go ahead and assume that we can just call it 3 apples per minute. Okay. And if you take a big, a big jump from this minute to that minute, and how many apples are picked, you probably get a good average, a good estimate of how many minutes or how many apples every minute are being picked. So that was just a quick aside. So we'll just assume that every minute we're picking 3 apples. These are incredibly hard to pick, apparently, or they're very high, or they're huge, or they can be cut down with axes. I don't know why it's taking us a minute to pick 3 apples, but that's what it is. So using 3 apples per minute, can we go from something we know to something we want to know, like how many apples we would have after 51 minutes? You'd expect we could do that, right? We can start here. I know how many I go up by every. I mean, the long way would be start with 15, right? All right, let's start further ahead. Start with 30 and then add on 3 and add on 3 again and add on 3 again and add on 3 again and add on 3 again. Until you get to 51 minutes, right? But that's going to take a painfully long time. Instead, maybe, let's try this, because this is really what I would recommend if I was going to try and especially write a formula here. We back up to minute 0. We just back right up to minute 0.
Yeah.
How many apples would I have started with? How many apples would I have already had at minute 0?
5, 9, 5, 9, 3, 5, 9, 3,
and what? 12. Well, how would we figure it out? There were 15 that we have 15, in the basket at 2 minutes. Well, how many must I have picked from minute 1 to minute 2?
3 apples per minute.
So that backs me up to 12. Well, that's minute 1. What about minute 0? That's 3 more. Right, 2 minutes difference here. So 6 apples difference. So 9. So we start out at the very good, you know, the beginning. It's a good place to start. Let's start with 9 apples. Then we're gonna add. Well, I could start with 9, I could just add 3. And add 3, and add 3, and add 3. You see what I'm doing there?
Mm-hmm.
This gives me 12. Add 3 to that, this gives me 15. Add 3 to that, that gives me 18. Add 3 to that, that gets me up to 21, and I just keep adding on until I get up to 51, minute 51. How many 3s would I have to add on if I start here at minute 0, and I'm trying to get up to 51? How many minutes are going to go by if I start at minute 0, go all the way to minute
51?
51. Didn't fall for the trap. Not 50. 51 minutes go by if we start at minute 0. So how many 3s am I going to add on? 51 3s. Is there a faster way to add 51 threes?
51 times 3.
3 times
3.
51.
Okay.
51 times 3, 3 times 51, it's all the same thing. So 9 plus 3 times 51.
3 times 51 is 153 plus
9.
162.
162.
Oh. 162
right there.
Oh.
How about for minute X? Minute X, we start with the 9 apples at minute 0. Add on 3 every minute. How many minutes are going to go by?
51.
Okay, yeah, for 51 minutes we go by. How about for minute all the way to minute X? How many minutes will go by to get to minute
X?
X minutes. X minutes. Not X minus 1. We're not starting at minute 1, we're starting at minute 0. At the very beginning. So X minutes. X 3s I need to add on. 9 plus 3 times x. Formula. And now we can use it for anything. I can plug in there for 51 minutes, 107 in there for 107 minutes, right? Just follows that pattern of three apples every minute for X minutes starting at 0 minutes. Is that? So it's this matter of like, oh, things are skipping around. I'm not going from minute one to minute two as we conveniently did before. We're skipping around. So let me just give you three more. If you finish them before class is over, then you finish before class is over, you're all done. If you need to continue and do the rest for homework, continue to do the rest for homework.
Wait, what are you trying to say?
You're going to turn it